Hello everybody, thanks for watching. This is a remake of the Albino Deer video. We decided to make a director's cut where we voice over the entire thing. There's our cat and BB-8. So I'm Jason.
And I'm Julian.
And we are Yemen Nation. Everything you see in this video is original footage that we took mostly in our own yard. We were lucky enough one year to have an albino deer living back and forth in our yard every day. So, where are we, Julian?
We are in our backyard right now.
Yeah, this is a day I'll never forget. Coming home from work on a fall day and looking into the woods, I saw something shiny and bright. I couldn't believe my eyes. So one cool thing about this deer is he was not scared of people. So you can see we're walking right up to him today. Were you with me this day, Julian?
Yeah.
How close were we?
Like 5 feet.
5 feet? Yeah, even some of our neighbors could walk right up to him and feed him. You'll see how close we can actually get.
We are getting pretty close, but something will happen. It doesn't really like us that much.
So what was your favorite thing about this deer?
Probably because it's like a kind of a rare, like, version.
A rare version of a deer?
Yeah.
Yeah, I agree. Unfortunately, the deer passed away. Do you remember how it passed away? Do you remember what happened?
It got hit by a car.
Yeah, over by the West Side Fire Station. So if anybody was wondering, this deer lived in the Bear's Den area of Mill Creek Park for about a year and a half. We found out that he was a buck because right before he got hit by a car, he started growing horns.
And if you look on his back right leg, you can actually see he got hit by something. And it must have hurt.
So we're just scrolling through a few more pictures here. Coming up is about to be a picture of Julian standing right next to the deer.
Yeah,
right here. Even the picture doesn't do justice how close they actually were. So here's our front yard. Some of you guys might recognize Bear's Den Road here. See, he used to run around with other deer. Stood out, stopped traffic every time he was running by.
Because everybody wanted to see him because it was a rare type of deer. And they really wanted to see it.
So here you can see the video changes. This is over kind of by the Rocky Ridge Park, where it's in that patch of trees where they grow maple syrup every year. Or I said they grow maple syrup. they harvest maple syrup on the maple trees right here. So we were just driving home one day. Of course, you could see the deer stands right out. So this is another day we walked right up to him.
Yeah, we were trying to get really close again, but it ran away. It kept running away from us again.
But if you pay attention too, you can see other deer in this video. They don't let you get as close, but the white deer just never really seemed to be too scared of people. So in the last minute, I wanted to talk to you guys what inspired me to revisit this video and share some of the memories we had watching this deer. Recently we had some books donated to our school at Kirkmere, and my son was reading him one night for his homework on a night that I had to stay late. And
two of the books were about, like, albino deer.
And it turns out that the albino deer, when we looked closely at the pictures, was this deer. So somebody got some great photographs and actually wrote some children's books about this. So hope you enjoyed.
And don't forget to like and subscribe.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.